the following podcast on why hippos are not good pets has been canceled. For the following podcast, after you listen to it, would make you rather be eaten by a hippo than listen to another one of these hideous podcasts. Mr. Announcer, you're fired again! Oh, well, two times the charm. Or three times, or...
Hello, I'm Granny G, and welcome to the Granny G Podcast Show. I'm your host.
Granny G, it's my podcast show, the Jason Funny Podcast Show. So get out of the way.
You get out of the way. I'll push you back.
Easy. Granny G, stop. Whoa.
Yeah, that's right. Let's go to a song.
Hey, I'm supposed to say that.
It's a beautiful thing.
Well, that definitely didn't go very well. Granny G had to go to the bathroom. At her age, she always has to go to the bathroom. Anyway, we got a very special podcast show for you, the second podcast show. And we're going to be interviewing the one and only Webby, which is the founder of Backyard Beatdown from the Webby Wrestling with Webby YouTube channel. And a lot of you know, if you're familiar with my channel, that I'm connected to Wrestling with Webby channel. It's pretty much gives grown men an excuse to be boys again. So yeah, the Wrestling with Webby YouTube channel, and we'll be interviewing Webby about Backyard Beatdown, how he came up with the concept of Backyard Beatdown. So we're only going to have two songs for this particular podcast. Usually I want to do three songs for every podcast. We're going to only have two. And after this second one, we'll have the exclusive interview, which will be over 10 minutes long, with the one and only Webby. So, and of course, Webby used to have the Webby Report here on this channel. And Webby's been part of my channel since almost the beginning here on at KJOW42 Productions. So you have listened to a lot of my stuff, or you're familiar with know who Webby is. And we'll have an interview with him right after this song. Like I said, we'll just do two songs and end it here. So that should be interesting though. You should have to listen. So we're not going to really have a lot of characters on this particular podcast. And Granny G hopefully will not be back from the bathroom for a while. So after this song, enjoy this song and then enjoy this interview with the one and only Webby. Though, and it should be interesting. And if you don't know much about it, go to Wrestling with Webby YouTube channel, and it'll show the Backyard Beatdown series, and then you'll understand a little bit more what we're talking about. Hashtag Wrestling with Webby. We'll be right back with Webby right after this very unique song. Whoops. Thank you. Well, welcome back here. I hope you enjoyed that song. That's the last song of the podcast, and to end this podcast here, also we have in the studios the founder and the boss of Backyard Beatdown from the Wrestling with Webby YouTube channel.
Well, you make me sound like I'm evil or something.
Mr. Webster! What?
You make me sound like I'm evil.
Nothing! No! I just... You know what? You know, David Austin says I'm billionaire. Rich people won't give him a break in life.
Well, I don't know about all that.
But anyway, we're here with Webby, and we're going to ask what, you know, the Backyard Beatdown on his channel has got him quite a bit of views. I mean, you know, I believe one of the Backyard Beatdown matches had close to 1,000 views.
1,300.
Yeah. And so, I mean, a lot of us small YouTube channels like us would love to have that many views. And so, this idea, though, of this Backyard Beatdown must have started somewhere. So there must have been a snowball effect. So I want you to explain to those on the podcast the snowball effect, what created Backyard Beatdown. I guess it was last year it started.
Yeah, it was last year that started. Honestly, you know, me and my brother and my friend's idea, honestly, because, you know, me and my brother decided to invest and get some equipment and create this studio, and he wanted to create his own channel and stuff, kicking it with Coach Webb or the Coach Webb podcast. And my friend decided, hey, you want to go have this wrestling match and all that kind of stuff, and Farva decided he wanted to come and be a referee for it, and... So we did that, and
so that started in a conversation. That you just talking one day, and
that started doing that, and we went and did that match in the backyard, and that grew to you versus David Awesome.
I don't know how you talked me into that one,
because we decided that we wanted to have more people involved in it, and that grew to having different matches.
And he was my mortal enemy on YouTube anyway.
Yeah, and he has a better channel than you sometimes too.
I see where you're at. You're on my podcast, but then you promote his channel. Okay, yeah,
well, you know, you have to promote the corporate champion.
His channel of shooting baskets on a basketball court, that's the most boring videos I've ever seen.
I'm just kidding, Jason. You know, but anyway, so yeah, you know, that's kind of where it started, and it just grew from there.
Because on the newest Backyard Beatdown that we'll be recording this afternoon, we're going to have quite a few people involved. It started with just two or three people, and now we're going to have six or seven people, eight people involved with the refereeing, ringing the bell. We got referees, and we got trampoline now, and we got all these new people coming in with their own personalities.
Yeah, you got you... Jason Cole, love to run your mouth, and you got Coach Webb sometimes, you got me, the owner, and...
Your brother hadn't been on this year's...
Not this year, but... not maybe, this year yet, but...
maybe he'll appear and make a surprise appearance.
And then you got Reckoning and Big Country Duncan.
Pumpkin?
Or Pumpkin, as you like to say. And then you got David Awesome and Andy Cool and Farva and Mikey. And
quite a bit of people involved this time. And even...
Every once in a while, Matt M.
was referee for a couple of the first episodes here in season two. And also sometimes the
crazy
kid.
Crazy... Ginger,
a bat girl.
Yeah, as you like to call her. So we got quite a few people.
And then also sometimes the kids are involved with helping out. Like your first a few Backyard Beatdowns, your niece and stuff was involved a little bit, wasn't she?
And with the interviews.
Yeah, and they helped out when you got...
when I had my car.
When you got clobbered in that boxing match. Barbara.
Yeah, and there was kind of a out in the crowd like thing, though.
Yeah.
And I really liked it. I've been watching some of the matches lately.
You were you were so infatuated with George Foreman helping you.
And well, you know,
that was a story anyway.
Yeah, and Faba wanted to involve the kids at the end, and we didn't do it. And I wish we would have done it now. Well, all the kids and him stomped the crap out of me after the boxing match. That would have been, because I've been running my mouth. That would have been hilarious. But I was going to say, I made another point too, and I almost forgot what it is. It's I've been listening to some of the older matches from last year, and your brother does an outstanding job with commentary. But what cracked me up, he made several comments that cracked me up when I was wrestling last year. I was coming down I think it was either commentary with Mikey or somebody or you, and somebody had said, you know, Jason's come across a lot of money and he's pretty wealthy now, you know, kind of like JBL. Yeah. But then your brother said, well, yeah, but what is that car? Is that a Corolla? And I just busted up laughing because, like, a Corolla is an economic car. And I laughed so hard because I thought it was kind of a dry delivery, but it was hilarious. Oh, yeah, well, he's running into money, you know. He's. I think it was Mikey that said it. And then I was coming out. The kid opened the door for me. And he said, yeah, but is that a Corolla? You know, it's like, yeah, he's coming to money, but he's not driving a limousine. You know, like JBL drove a big limousine with horns on here. I'm driving a little Corolla. It was a parody, kind of.
Yeah,
but
of course you had to correct them and tell them what it actually was.
Yeah, yeah, a big long limousine. I said something in effect, and but it was
in reality, all you drive is a Smurfmobile.
The extended Smurfmobile.
Yeah,
from the original one I had, I think everybody. I think you know everybody was a little nervous because like I haven't wrestled in a long time, and then I was going to wrestle David. But I think the match ended up being a lot better than anybody thought it would be. They was kind of nervous it wouldn't be that good. But I think we did a pretty good show. The only problem I had is I wanted David at the end. I was just so tired and so out of shape. And I weighed like 10 more pounds.
500 pounds.
Yeah, I wouldn't go that far. But I weighed about 15 more pounds than I do now.
I don't know. You ever seen Yokozuna wrestle?
Well, that's Jason. Don't get carried away if you go back and see it. I'm not that big, but I was about 15 pounds heavier than I am now. And that's a lot of weight to carry around when you're 45 years old. And, you know,
he did a good job, and I'm just kidding about that.
Well, the point I was trying to make with my extra weight that I had, because I have lost about 15 pounds since last year. I'm very proud of that. As you can tell, I don't have the gut like I had. But... I was wanting David to end the match.
I was about to die.
I mean, I couldn't breathe. I was getting dizzy. I was just about to die. I was sweating like a stuck pig. And I had all that extra weight on me that I don't have now. And I was miserable. I said, David, end the match. David, end the match. What? No. Well, I want to do some more stuff. And I was just like, in time the match was over with, he finally pinned me, finally did it, and I was like, finally the match is over with. And I just thought to myself, I can't do this again, you know, because I just, my age and my weight and stuff, and I just couldn't do it anymore. I said, you know, I did this one match, then I ended up doing that boxing match with Faba, which, you know, was a character within itself.
It was a character within itself.
If I just had those kids, because I was kind of rude to some of the kids, you know, in some of the interviews. Oh, what's the girl? Was that the girl that interviewed me?
They were my nieces.
Okay, I was a little bit rude to them. So it would have been funny after that boxing match if the kids, you know, got a couple cheap shots in at the end. And Faba said, you know, I was going to do that, and I forgot all about it. Because Jason, you know, Cole, I was called Jason Funny then, like I am now, but I had that Cole attitude and that Cole mouth, and Michael Cole mouth, and So I thought it would have been a good idea that that would have happened. But anyway, yeah, I think I did better with just doing what I do best, and that's running my mouth and stuff, so. But no, I was not Yokozuna.
I'm just joking.
So I was, but as I look back at that match with David, I was pretty large, but my weight came to advantage in that match. The problem was I wore out faster. But I mean, I slung David.
Oh no, you did. You did a pretty good job.
I slung David around like a.
You did a pretty good job with those towel moves at the beginning.
Yeah, everybody said.
Well, of course, you know.
Everybody said, "Stop using that towel. Don't bring that towel down there. Don't use it as a weapon. You can't use a towel as a weapon." I'm pretty clever with that stuff.
Of course, you know. My brother made some pretty funny comments about that towel, too, so...
Yeah, I figured he'd make some little comments about it. A lot of people thought it was stupid, but I thought it worked out just fine. It gave me some leverage. But David was easy to bounce around because he was so skinny. And I just whipped him around like he was just a little... I think I dominated most of that match up until the end when I wore out. I watched the match. I dominated most of that match, but it was just like I was about to die. But anyway, Backyard Beatdown continues to be successful. Go to the hashtag Webby or Wrestling with Webby on YouTube, and they have the Backyard Beatdown series. Originally, his channel was a review on WWE Raw and SmackDown,
which you'll see some of that on there too,
which is still on his channel. But, you know, he got tired of 5 views, so he just wanted to...
What?
I had to get you back about the weight thing. But
you have to add some variety besides just wrestling previews. And
that's all he is. He's only a wrestling channel. He does not vlog.
Look, if you like wrestling content and... vlogs every once in a while.
He does not vlog.
Look, if you like wrestling content, come over to my channel. Hashtag Wrestling with Webby.
I just plugged it, and you'll plug it. You get a double plug?
Absolutely.
Oh, for God, heaven's sake. Well, this is the end. Let's get out of here. We're fixing to leave here in a little while to Backyard Beatdown, so we're going to end this podcast here. Remember, like, you know, we all promote his channel, promote my channel, like, subscribe. If you like this,
and subscribe
podcast,
to it. Hey, and remember to subscribe to it today.
Yes, to this podcast.
To mine.
To the podcast and the channel.
And remember to become a funny tuber
today. And a Backyard Beatdown fan if you're not. Webby, you know, Webby is playing the corporate boss. This time, and you got them double X clothes he puts on, and
shut up, Jason Funny and Webby. Both of you are done. This is the Granny G podcast show. It's the Jason Funny podcast. Shut up.